Hello and welcome to another episode in the Godot Basics Tutorial Series. In this episode, we'll be taking a look at categories of game programming. In your programming journey, or rather your game programming journey, you'll run into three different types of areas of game programming. They are game scripting, third-party modules, and engine programming. There are more, however, these are the common ones you'll find yourself running into. Let's go ahead and take a look at them. So the first area is engine programming, and this is the hardest to do. What you're basically doing is programming to create an engine or framework that other programmers can use to write their games in. For example, engine programming would be as if you were helping the Godot community by fixing bugs in the Godot engine framework. Not only is it possible to help the Godot engine framework, however, you could create your own competitor to the Godot engine framework, or write your own game framework for your own custom game. However, some people may find it appealing to program at that level, and that is available, and that is within the realm of game programming. The next thing is third-party modules. Now, you'll quickly learn that games are just multiple mini projects put together. Take, for example, a dialogue system you find in visual novels, shooting physics, and network calls like HTTP requests. And there's much, much more. What third-party modules do is that instead of a programmer implementing their own dialogue system, for example, they could easily download a third-party module, a third-party dialogue system from somewhere, and then just add that code to their game. Now, that is another area of game programming. Some people try to create common functionalities and features that others can use to help them create games. And you can make money like this. People will purchase a dialogue system so they don't have to write that code for themselves. The pros for you as a beginner programmer using third-party modules is that you have more time to focus on your core gameplay. That's one thing to keep in mind. By downloading code that does what you need, you have more time to focus on other areas. For example, your game needs a dialogue system, but a dialogue system is not part of the core gameplay. You could focus more time in, for example, your shooting physics. However, one thing to keep in mind is the negatives that come with third-party modules. As a beginner, third-party modules are crutches, so use them as beginners, but slowly understand the concepts behind the implementations and improve from that understanding. Basically, to grow as a programmer, you need to let go of third-party modules and start learning how to implement them yourself. Manually. Now, the last area of game programming is game scripting. This is the general vision or the general picture in your head when you think of game programmer. And that's basically writing code that turns into a game to be consumed by users. This is the programming this series will help you understand and teach you to do. Now, there are many different areas of game scripting. There's environmental scripting, there's player scripting, there's animation scripting, much, much more. However, keep in mind that most of the time you will be handling game scripting. So before you try to get into third-party modules or even game engines, first understand how to program making games. Well, that's all I have for you in this episode. Thank you for joining me. I hope you learned a lot. I look forward to seeing you in the next episode. Have an amazing day.